Finally, the Wahoo has come back to YouTube. Now here, on WrestleMania weekend, the Wahoo has noticed that many of you comic book jabronis are also fans of professional wrestling. And so today, the Wahoo wants to talk about why the Wahoo thinks so many comic book fans are also wrestling fans. But before we get into that, I want to know, is the Wahoo's theory correct? Tell me in the comments below, are you a professional wrestling fan or not? And if you are, tell me, who is your favorite wrestler of all time? Now, the Wahoo thinks that there are a lot of reasons why comic book fans are also wrestling fans, but the primary reason, the Wahoo thinks, is because it shows our love of superheroes. Because after all, professional wrestlers are basically real-life superheroes. Of course, they look like superheroes, and that's why many of them have even been cast into comic book movies. Of course, you have Batista as Drax, John Cena as Peacemaker, The Rock as Black Adam, and many others. And they also do superhuman things in the ring. I mean, just a few months ago, the Wahoo's favorite wrestler of all time, Sting, as a 65-year-old man, climbed up a ladder and jumped off of it through a table.
What the hell is Sting doing?
What are you doing, Sting?
Sting, what the hell?
Oh, no, come on now. No!
No, 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 no. No.
Oh,
no.
I don't believe it either, guy. He is out of his freaking mind.
There's no way he's going to reach.
He is out of his freaking mind.
It's too far away.
Payback. The Forbidden Door.
Of course, most 20-year-olds couldn't do that, much less the 65-year-old superhero known as Sting. And obviously, he even wears the face paint to show us that he is a superhero. You have some more obvious examples like The Undertaker, who takes a superhuman amount of punishment, and then all of a sudden, when Paul Bearer raises the urn, he sits up.
Oh boy, Undertaker's the challenger!
And there are countless examples of other wrestlers doing superhuman things. Now, a question is, why are we so drawn to the superheroes both in comic books and the wrestling ring? And I think there are many reasons, but one of the main ones is that I believe these characters give us the chance to escape the suffering that we all go through in this world, if only for just a few minutes, and live our dreams out through these characters. Of course, the characters that we love the most are the ones that we can see ourselves living through. One of the reasons that we all love Peter Parker so much is that he begins his life being socially ostracized and bullied, which I'm willing to bet that many of us can identify with. Certainly, I was bullied quite a bit as a kid. But then in the story, Peter Parker gets his powers and is able to overcome that bully Flash Thompson. When we read that, we relate to that and we live out his dream. Yeah, who's the Flash in my life? Oh, I want to do that to him. In the same way, when we watch Stone Cold stand up to his boss, give him a stunner and some one-finger salutes.
Oh, he's gonna get it again! A rattlesnake strike!
We all relate to that and think of, oh man, when my boss treats me poorly, I want to give him a stunner. And so when we see Stone Cold do that, we live vicariously through him. And these characters, again, just fulfill our fantasies. And so we love to read about them and we love to watch them. Now, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, Do so now for some great content, and that's the bottom line, because the Wahoo said so. Now, something the Wahoo finds interesting about the comic and wrestling industries is that both go through ups and downs in popularity. And right now, the WWE has kind of been gaining popularity, while comics, especially the MCU, have been declining in popularity. And I think the MCU could learn a lesson from what the WWE is doing right now. Right now, the WWE has built up Roman Reigns to be an unstoppable villain. He's been champion for over 3 years, and though a few people have come close to beating him, no one has been able to topple him. And because of his dominance, we are all so invested in seeing him finally toppled, which many of us believe and hope will be done by Cody Rhodes this WrestleMania weekend. And in the first three phases of the MCU, Marvel did a great job of this with Thanos. They built him up to be this unstoppable threat, and even though the heroes came close to defeating him in Infinity War, they ended up failing.
I told you. You'd die for that.
Much like Cody Rhodes failed to dethrone Roman Reigns last year, and because Thanos was just so unstoppable, we were all so invested in Endgame and seeing him finally get his comeuppance. But sadly, the MCU began to depart from that model with Phase 4 as they begin to build up to Kang being the final boss. But instead of making him a dominant villain, they had him be defeated. First in Loki, and then you finally see him again in Ant-Man, and he's defeated again. And of course the storyline is, well, you're going to have a bunch of kings, and then together they're going to be a threat. But from what we've seen, he's not a threat at all. And obviously there's been things going on with Jonathan Majors that have affected the character outside of the movies. But even if none of that happened, I think it would be hard for all of us still to really be invested in the downfall of Kang in the same way that we were invested in the downfall of Thanos and in the way that WWE fans are invested in the downfall of Roman Reigns. And so personally, I think the MCU have jobbed out Kang too many times for us to care, and they need to pivot away from him being the final boss, which they might be forced to do now with Jonathan Majors and all of his stuff. And you know, from a business standpoint, that actually might work in Marvel's favor, because now they can create some whole new villain to be a final threat. And of course, if you watch the Wahoo's channel, you know that I hope that would be Dr. Doom. But whoever it is, we need a villain that seems unstoppable, unbeatable, that needs every hero to come together to defeat him. So Kevin Feige, called Triple H, get some ideas and help the MCU get back to where it once was. Now, what do you think? Do you agree the MCU has a final boss problem? Or do you even see any connection between comics and wrestling like I do? Or is this just another crazy thing the Wahoo has thought of? Again, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do so now. Like, comment, thank you.